Egypt is one of the most vulnerable countries when it comes to climate change.
Extreme weather, water scarcity, rising sea levels. Climate change is transforming Egypt, and Egypt is adapting.
If we follow the different scenarios developed by the IPCC, or the Intergovernmental Panel of Experts in Climate Change, we might end up by increase in the sea level by 30 centimeters up to 2050, which is of course gonna be reduce the crop productivity from the soil, will also impact the soil salinity on the long run, and the increase of temperature in Egypt will affect the required water for irrigation, the required water for industry, the required water for domestic uses.
Without measures to adapt, the well-being of Egyptians, even in sectors such as tourism and leisure, would be negatively affected, which is why the government is taking action.
We have been establishing a National Council for Climate Change. We have been drafting our national strategy for climate change.
Climate policies in Egypt cover both adaptation and mitigation initiatives. Adaptation policies focus on adjustments to limit the negative impact of climate change, while mitigation initiatives are part of global efforts to reduce the extent of climate change through reducing greenhouse gas emissions. In Egypt, adaptation includes efforts to adapt to a hotter, more arid climate, for example, through improving irrigation. Mitigation policies are supporting a transition to green energy. Green finance has an important role to play in helping Egypt achieve its adaptation and mitigation goals. Egypt is implementing policies designed to build resilience, promote a green economy, and catalyze private sector investment. As host of the COP27 Climate Conference in 2022, Egypt is also working to accelerate international action on climate change. Increased participation from the private sector is vital to scaling up the adaptation efforts. One example of this private adaptation is Plug and Grow, a company pioneering soilless agriculture in Egypt.
The Egyptian agriculture sector, like many Mediterranean countries, is quite affected by climate changes, not just with the rising temperatures and the heat waves that are actually affecting farms across the country and reducing their output to as low as 10 to 20%. With traditional agriculture, you face several abnormalities and challenges. With soilless agriculture, you basically have a completely controlled system which allows you to grow each crop basically at the same exact quality as the one next to it.
As part of its drive towards a greener future, Egypt is developing policies to catalyze financing.
We have been developing our green financing framework. This has been approved and was designed in alignment with international best practices. We were able also to issue the first sovereign green bond in the region.
A green bond is a debt instrument from which the allocation has to be used to finance projects that are environmentally friendly and have a positive impact on the environment.
We have used the allocation of this bond to finance projects in clean transportation and in sustainable water and wastewater management. More than 15 projects have been financed so far under our green financing framework.
Commercial International Bank, Egypt's largest private-owned bank, together with the International Finance Corporation, issued the region's first private green bond in 2021, worth $100 million.
The green bond is important because it signifies the capacity of the public and private sector to unlock investment interests towards green projects. But let's be very clear that the issuance of green bonds, whether on the sovereign level or on the CEIB level, establish the infrastructure, the foundation for scaling into adaptation. So now we have the know-how, and we expect adaptation projects to gain momentum in 2022 prior to COP27.
What I would hope in the future that these actions to be more and more green, nature-based. That's what will really position Egypt in a good situation when it comes to climate change.
I'm optimistic because not only the steps that's taking, I'm very optimistic because there is much more awareness now at the highest level and at all levels, globally, regionally, locally.